हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस आर न्यू सब्जेक्ट दैट इज कॉल्ड एज फ्लूड मशीनरी। एंड इन दिस सब्जेक्ट वी यूटिलाइज द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ फ्लूड मैकेनिक्स। सो द वेरी फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ दिस सब्जेक्ट इज इम्पैक्ट ऑफ जेट। सो बिफोर स्टार्टिंग इम्पैक्ट ऑफ जेट, आई वुड लाइक टू टेल यू द डेफिनेशन ऑफ फ्लूड मशीनरी। सो what is fluid machinery? Fluid machinery is what? Fluid machinery is the machine that converts the energy stored in a fluid mass to mechanical energy, or we can convert mechanical energy into fluid energy with the help of fluid machines. It means जो आपकी water में energy होती है वो बेटा कौन कौन सी होती है? पोटेंशियल एनर्जी, काइनेटिक एनर्जी एंड इंटरमोलिकुलर एनर्जी। दिस टाइप ऑफ एनर्जी दैट इज वाटर इटसेल्फ कंटेनिंग इज कन्वर्टेड इनटू मैकेनिकल एनर्जी विद द हेल्प ऑफ फ्लूइड मशीनरी। एंड फ्लूइड मशीन्स इज द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ थर्मोडायनामिक्स एंड फ्लूइड मैकेनिक्स। एंड द एनर्जी डेवलप्ड बाय द फ्लूइड मशीनरी दैट इज मैकेनिकल एनर्जी इज ट्रांसमिटेड to the generator shaft for its further use, for example generation of electricity. So this is a short introduction of fluid machinery. Now we are going to start the impact of jet chapter. So I'm going to start introduction of impact of jet. So as we know that when the liquid coming out in the form of jet, for example water is coming out of the pipe, and if you put your finger, then it takes the form of a jet. So the liquid come out in the form of jet from the outlet of nozzle with a high velocity, and that is having a high kinetic energy, because we know that एक object एक water fluid जिसकी velocity अगर high है तो उसकी kinetic energy भी high होगी उसमें. So the jet coming out of the nozzle impinges on the plate. अगर किसी भी plate पे उस वाटर को इम्पिंज किया जाएगा विच इज हैविंग द हाई वेलोसिटी, ठीक है, इट एक्सर्ट्स अ हाइड्रो फोर्स ड्यू टू चेंज इन इट्स मोमेंटम। देयर इज अ चेंज इन इट्स मोमेंटम, दैट इज अ मोमेंटम ऑफ वाटर व्हेन इट स्ट्राइक द प्लेट। सो वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट दैट हाउ मच फोर्स इट विल स्ट्राइकिंग द प्लेट। सो दिस हाइड्रोडायनामिक फोर्स इज इवेल्यूएटेड बाय यूजिंग इंपल्स मोमेंटम इक्वेशन or the impulse momentum principle that we have already learned in a previous subject, that is fluid mechanics. So in this chapter we are going to learn the application of impulse momentum equation for evaluating the hydrodynamic force on the stationary and moving plate. Ab aapke ek mind mein question aa raha hai, stationary moving plate to ek bar ko samajh mein aata hai, lekin stationary plate means? So beta aapne dams dekhe honge, theek hai, डैम्स में क्या होता है, आपको वाटर आपके डैम्स के थ्रू फ्लो कराया जाता है, ठीक है, और वहां जो फोर्स लगती है उस वाटर की हेल्प से ऑन द बाउंड्रीज ऑफ द डैम, ठीक है, दैट इज कंसीडर्ड टू बी द स्टेशनरी प्लेट। मूविंग प्लेट का आपको बहुत इजी एग्जांपल है, आपने टर्बाइन्स के बारे में सुना होगा, हाइड्रोलिक टर्बाइन, तो मूविंग प्लेट का आपका वहां यूटिलाइजेशन हो जाता है, ठीक है। सो देयर आर मेनी केसेस ऑफ इंपैक्ट ऑफ जेट। द फॉलोइंग केसेस ऑफ द इंपैक्ट ऑफ जेट दैट इज the force exerted by the jet on a plate will be considered in the two cases. First one is the force exerted by the jet on a stationary plate. So we have three parts in this case. First part is plate is vertical to the jet if the jet is striking normal to the plate and this plate is stationary. Second plate is plate is inclined to the jet, it means jet is striking in its normal direction but the plate is at certain angle, so it is having some inclination with respect to this jet. And next is plate is curved. If the plate is curved and the jet is striking this curved plate, what is the amount of force exerted by this curved plate by this jet? Next case is force exerted by the jet on a moving plate. In the previous case the plate is stationary, whether it is vertical, whether it is inclined, whether it is curved. Now the case is changed. Now the plate is moving. with the jet. If jet is striking the plate, this plate is moving, and this is vertical to this jet, normal to this jet. Now the plate is inclined and it is in moving condition with respect to this jet. Now the jet is in a curve shape and this is moving with respect to this jet. So we have two cases. In first case we have a stationary plate, in the second case we have moving plate. So first we will discuss stationary plate cases. So first we learn that how the force is exerted by the jet on a plate, whether it is moving or whether it is stationary. So this is a nozzle through which a mass of fluid is coming out and it is striking the plate, whether it is straight, inclined or curved, and it is having the velocity v1. M dot is the mass flow rate of water which strike the body. Let us, this is the body. So what force will be exerted on this plate? That is, Fp is the net change in linear moment of the water. So what is Fp? Fp is equals to moment of water at the exit. It means momentum of water at the exit. It means this is the exit point. It means striking point minus momentum of water at the entry. This is entry and this is exit. Initial minus final momentum. Initial minus final momentum. So F plate is equals to M dot V1. It means the total momentum of this water jet at the striking point of this plate. That is M dot into V1. So this is the momentum of water at the striking of the plate minus M dot V2. M dot V2, the mass of water striking, coming out through this plate, and the velocity of the jet after leaving the plate, that is V2. So M dot V1 minus M dot V2 is the force exerted by the jet on the plate. So this is the basic equation that we have to use in each of the cases we will discuss. So the case one is jet striking stationary vertical plate normal to the direction of the jet. It means this is a nozzle and this is a jet of the water which is coming out from this nozzle, and the nozzle is having the diameter d. M dot is the mass flow rate of water. V1 is the velocity of the fluid which is coming out of the nozzle, and it is striking the plate which is stationary, that is fixed. It means when the plate is stationary, there will be no motion in the plate when jet strikes the plate. And it is considered that the same amount of the mass flow rate will come out from the exit point of the plate. It means M dot by 2, M dot by 2. And this is V2, the exit velocity. This is the exit velocity. So what will be the area of nozzle? The area of nozzle is just to pi by 4 d square, because d is the diameter of nozzle. And what will be the mass flow rate? Mass flow rate will be rho a v1, or we can say that rho q. So rho a v1 is the mass flow rate of the water which is coming out through this nozzle. So now what will be the initial momentum of the jet coming out from this nozzle? That will be M dot V1, M dot V1 minus, what we have to do, we have to take the momentum with respect to the x direction at the exit point. So at the exit point, the velocity will remain, the velocity of the plate will remain zero, because it is stationary, and the mass flow rate that is coming out of the exit of this plate is M dot by 2, M dot by 2. So what will be the momentum at this point? M dot by 2 into V, M dot by 2 into V. So what will be the amount of force in the direction of the jet? It means we will talking about Fx. So Fx or normal force will be m dot v1. It means initial momentum of the jet minus final momentum, that will be m dot by 2 into 0. 0 is because plate is not moving, it is stationary, plus m dot by 2 into 0. This m dot by 2 is considered because the water is considered to come out from the jet after striking the plate from this point and in this direction. So this is m dot by 2. So we can see that this is 0, this value is 0. So final, what is the value of Fx? Fx is equals to m dot v1, that is, what is the value of m dot? M dot is a mass value, that is rho a v1, rho a v1. So rho a v1 into v1 is equals to rho a v1 square. So this will be the value of Fx, or we can say that the normal force which is exerting on the plate with respect to this jet, with respect to this jet. Now, what will be the value of plate, force in y direction? In y direction, we have already calculated the force in x direction. Now, what will be the value of force in y direction? That is the tangential force. We are talking about the tangential force in this direction. So, what will happen? In y direction, there is no force or the no momentum of the jet, because V is applying in this direction, x direction. There is no velocity component in y direction. So it is m dot into 0. M dot means mass flow rate into 0. V is 0 in y direction, minus m dot by 2. M dot by 2 because water is coming out from both the side of the plate. So m dot by 2 into V2. Into V2. At this point, it is considered to be V2. If this is V2 and this is in the downward direction, this is minus V2. So therefore, m dot into 0 minus m dot by 2 into V2 plus m dot by 2 into minus V2. This is in y upward direction and this is in downward direction. So this is the value is 0 and this is also 0. So therefore, the force exerted by jet in y direction of the plate will be 0. So this is the important thing. When jet strike flat plate, there will apply the force only in normal direction to the plate and there will be no force in y direction. So this is how the force is calculated over the stationary plate when the jet is striking the plate normal to it. Okay, so I think this is clear to you. Next case is jet striking stationary inclined plate. Now the plate which is straight normal to the plate in previous case, now it is inclined. Now it is inclined. The jet is striking in this way and it is having some inclination. There is some angle in between the plate and this jet. So what we will do, this D is the diameter of this nozzle, M is the mass flow rate, V is the velocity of the jet which is coming out through the nozzle, and the inclination of the plate with respect to this jet is theta. So what will be the value of normal force? If we see that from this diagram, आपका जो जेट है वो इधर स्ट्रेट आ रहा है, बट दिस इज थीटा, ये कोई एक डायरेक्शन है, इंक्लिनेशन है. सो द वैल्यू ऑफ क्यू वन एंड क्यू टू इज डिफरेंट, एम वन एंड एम टू इज डिफरेंट व्हेन इट इज कमिंग आउट ऑफ द प्लेट. लेट द वैल्यू इज एम वन डॉट एम वन और क्यू वन एम डॉट टू क्यू टू. सो वॉट विल हैपन, m dot, that is the mass flow rate coming out through the nozzle, is equals to m dot 1 plus m dot 2, and q equals to the total discharge equals to q1 plus q2, and the mass flow rate of the water coming out through the nozzle can be considered as m dot rho a v1, where a is the diameter of this nozzle hole. So if we consider the normal force, what will be the amount of normal force? Normal force will be considered in this direction. So in this direction, the component of velocity will be v1 sin theta. Just aapka angle ke opposite jo value hoti hai, that will be sin theta. So v1 sin theta is the direction in this fn direction, and the value of this v will be zero because the plate is stationary. Jaise hamara pichle wale case mein tha, plate jab stationary hai to hamari jo velocity hogi wo zero hogi. So what will be happen? Initial momentum minus final momentum. Initial momentum kya aapka m dot v1 sin theta minus m dot 1, that is m dot 1 into zero, this velocity m dot 1 v1 plus m dot 2 into zero. This is zero because plate is stationary. So m dot v1 sin theta minus this value is zero because it is multiplying by zero velocity. So here the value of this normal force, the value of normal force will be m dot v1 sin theta. And what is the value of m dot? M dot will be rho a v1. So what will be the value of normal force? That is rho a v1 square sin theta. Now, if we have to find out the value of force exerted in x direction with respect to the jet, so what will be happening? This fx, the value of this fx, the value of this fx will be fn sin theta, fn sin theta, because this sin theta component of this fn will be fx. So fx equals to fn sin theta. We have already calculated the value of fn, rho a v1 square sin theta. So put the value of fn in this equation, we will get fx, and fx is equals to rho a v1 square sin theta into sin theta. That is fx equals to rho a v1 square sin square theta. This is the value of force exerted in x direction with respect to the inclined plate. Now what will be the value of force which is exerted in y direction with respect to the jet? That will be fy equals to fn cos theta. So put the value of fn in this equation and we will get the value of fy, and fy equals to rho a v1 into sin theta cos theta. Okay, so this is the value of y. Now we have already discussed that in this direction, in this diagram, the total amount of the discharge which is coming out of the nozzle is q, but at the exit of the plate the discharge is q1 and q2. So we find out the ratio of this q1 by q2. So for that we have to find out the value of tangential component of force and apply the momentum equation. So in this case, the tangential velocity component, the tangential velocity component is zero. So Ft equals to zero, and the value of Ft will be given by V1 cos theta into M dot minus M dot 1 V1 into M dot 2 minus V2. This. So solving this equation, we will get q cos theta minus q1 plus q2 equals to zero. We will put q1 instead of rho a this m dot v1. So rho, we will put the full value and find out the a v1. We will put q. So q equals to, and we already know that q equals to q1 plus q2. So So we have two equations, this q cos theta minus q1 plus q2 equals to 0 and q equals to q1 plus q2. So these are the two equations, we can solve it and we will able to find out the value of q1 by q2. So q1 by q2 equals to 1 plus cos theta divided by 1 minus cos theta. So this is the ratio of the outlet discharge at one side of the inclination of the plate divided by the discharge at the other side of the inclined plate. It means q1 divided by q2. Now the third case is jet striking at the center of symmetric curved plate. The jet striking at the center of symmetric curved plate. It means curved plate is like this, and the angle of inclination of this curvature will be theta from the center line. It means this is theta and this is also theta, like in this diagram. This is the curved plate and the jet is striking on this center of the curved plate with a velocity v1, and the mass flow rate of this jet is m dot, that is coming out through the nozzle. And with respect to this center line, this curvature angle is theta, this theta, and this alpha angle is angle of deflection, angle of deflection. So from this you can see that the water will exit in this direction, and if this is theta, then the velocity component of v in x direction will be minus v2 cos theta, and y direction is v2 sine theta, and the mass flow rate is equally divided into the on two sides, that is m dot by 2, m dot by 2. Similarly, here the component of this velocity is v2 cos theta with minus sign, because it is in opposite direction to this v1, and this downward direction minus v2 sin theta. It is going upward and this is coming downward. So this is minus v2 sin theta. So now again we will take the function of impulse momentum equation and find out the value of forces. So the mass flow rate will be rho a v1. So we can see that in all the cases the value of mass flow rate will remain same, that is rho a v1. So what will be the value of Fx, that is a force exerted by the jet on the curved vane in x direction, that is m dot into v1. This is the initial momentum. What will be the final momentum? Final momentum will be m dot by 2 into m dot by 2. We are taking in x direction, so we will take this component. So m dot by 2 into minus v2 cos theta plus m dot by 2 into minus v2 cos theta. So by solving this equation we will get fx equals to m dot v1 plus, agar aap in dono ko dekhenge ye bhi minus hai, ye bhi minus hai, ye bhi minus hai, so ye plus ho jayega, m dot v2 cos theta. And if v1 equals to v2, we are taking the assumption, so therefore vx equals to m dot v1 in bracket 1 plus cos theta. This is the value of force which is exerted on the curved vane in x direction, and putting the value of m dot, that is rho a v1. So we will get fx equals to rho a v1 square 1 plus cos theta. Now what will be the value of force in y direction, which is acting in y direction with respect to this curved plate? So in y direction we can see that the initial momentum is zero, because there is no water which is going in this direction with the velocity v1. So therefore m dot into 0, that is 0 velocity, minus, we have to take this component of velocity v2 sin theta into m dot by 2 minus v2 sin theta into m dot by 2. So ye cancel out ho jayenge aur ye bhi 0 hai, to fy aapka kya ho jayega beta, 0. Fy is 0. It means the value of fy for the symmetric plate, which is fixed, not moving, the value of force exerted in y direction will be 0. And the angle of deflection is given by 180 degree minus theta. Theta is the angle at which this is at the curvature. Case fourth is jet striking the stationary wind tangential in the tangential direction, and it is the case of unsymmetrical wind. Unsymmetrical wind. Unsymmetrical means आपने देखा होगा कर्वेचर में जब हमने पिछला वाला केस लिया था वो सिमेट्रिकल था, बोथ द एंगल आर इक्वल, थीटा थीटा, ठीक है. लेकिन इसमें क्या है, आपके एंगल दोनों डिफरेंट हो जाएंगे. इट मींस इफ दिस इज थीटा, इफ दिस इज फाई, एंड ईच एंड एवरीथिंग विल रिमेन सेम, सम चेंजेस विल टेक प्लेस ड्यू टू दिस चेंज इन इंक्लिनेशन. सो मास फ्लो रेट विल बी एम डॉट इक्वल्स टू रो ए वी वन. नाउ द जेट इज स्ट्राइकिंग इन सच अ वे दैट इट इज working tangential to this curve wave. So this is V1 and this V1 और यहाँ से भी आपका V1 ही निकलेगा बाहर, ठीक है. Taking the component of this V1 with respect to this theta, so it is coming in this direction, so it will also come in this direction. So minus V1 cos theta, and this will go in this direction, this is V1 sin theta. Similarly in this, if this is going in this direction, so the component of this V2 or V1 will come in this direction, in this direction. So it is minus V2 cos phi, and in y direction V2 sin phi, because this is the phi angle. This is theta and this is phi. With respect to this theta, we have to take theta, and with respect to phi, we have to take sin phi and cos phi. So what will be the value of force in x direction when the plate is curved and unsymmetrical and the jet is striking tangentially to this curved wave? So what will be the value of fx? Fx equals to what will be the value of x in this direction? This is this one, so this will be this is plus, I think, this is plus, this is not minus. So m dot v1 cos theta, m dot v1 cos theta, this is the initial momentum, this is the initial momentum, m1 m dot into v1 cos theta minus m dot into minus v2 cos phi. So it will be fx equals to m dot v1 cos theta plus v2 cos phi. If v1 equals to v2, then fx equals to, by putting the value of m dot equals to rho a v1. So rho a v1 square cos theta plus cos phi. This is the value of the force which is exerted by the jet when it is working tangentially to this unsymmetrical curve vane and it is stationary. What will be the value of Fy? Fy will be this V1 sin theta and V2 sin phi. We have to consider this. So Fy equals to M dot V1 sin theta minus V2 sin phi. This is the initial momentum and this is the final momentum. So Fy will be rho a V1 square sin theta minus sin phi. Okay. This is the formula for Fy exerted by the jet in y direction when the plate is unsymmetrical and the jet is striking tangentially. Now, if it is symmetrical plate, what will happen in case of symmetrical vane when the jet is striking tangentially? Take theta equals to phi. जब हमारा symmetrical होगा बेटा तो theta equals to phi हो जाएगा, and putting this in this equation, we will get fx equals to 2 rho a v1 square cos theta, because theta equals to phi, so we will get 2 cos theta. So fx equals to 2 rho a v1 square cos theta, and fy is sin theta minus sin phi. If both the values are similar, theta equals to phi, so it is 0, so fy equals to 0. So I think today's lecture is clear. We have already discussed impact of jet, in which case we have discussed the cases of stationary plates. In first case, the plate is normal to the jet. In second case, the plate is at the inclination with respect to the jet. In third case, the plate is symmetrical and it is acting at the center. The jet is striking the curved vane that is symmetrical in nature at the center. And in the fourth case, we have discussed that there is a unsymmetrical plate. The jet is striking tangentially to the curved vane. So these are the methods or the cases we have to discuss in this impact of jet with stationary plates. Okay. In our upcoming lecture, I will discuss the impact of jet in moving plates. Okay. So thank you so much and have a nice day. Take care of yourself. Thank you so much.